What's up, everyone? This is H.A. Duke, and it is 9 a.m. on Wednesday, and that means one thing. It is time for some HCW action. This is going to be the second episode of HCW BombShells, the newest show for HCW Call League. This is an all-female show, and we've got some pretty good matches lined up. We're actually going to have some rivalry start up on this show, hopefully try to get this show a little more interesting. So without any further ado, I'm going to go straight into the card, see who's up this week. So, kicking off the show, tag team action. It's a rematch from last week, as Candace Duke will be teaming up with Rachel Riley to take on Heaven and Ashley Good, better known as Simply Heavenly. And as you can tell, Heaven has actually got a little bit of a new look, kind of changed up her attire a little bit, and got rid of her perm and straightened her hair again. I don't know if that's going to have any effect on the outcome of the match, but we saw last week it was a crazy tag team match between these two teams. And finally, Candace Duke and Rachel Riley were able to pull up what a lot of people would consider a huge upset over the team of Simply Heavenly. Simply Heavenly does not like that. Very upset about the outcome of that match. Have issued a challenge here tonight. So it's going to be very interesting to see what happens. In our next matchup, we have a debuting female coming onto the show. Her name is Goldie Dawson. She comes straight out of the wrestling camp of Gregory Black, which, of course, we know who Gregory Black is. He's on Recharged. So this lady's been trained by him and comes out of his wrestling camp. And she has picked a fight with the former NXT or former HCW Women's Champion, Jennifer Faerkaine. As we remember last week, Jennifer Faerkaine was in a one-on-one match with Casey Armstrong, and she walked out in the match taking a count-out loss. Whenever she was interviewed later backstage about that, she basically said that she felt that she was insulted being put in a match with Casey Armstrong, that she's not a doll, she's not a bombshell, she's not a knockout, she's not a diva, and she wants real competition. Well, Goldie Dawson, coming onto the scene, took that as an opportunity to get herself involved in the show, issued a challenge to Jennifer Faerkaine. So we'll see what happens with that match. The third match on the show is going to be the Mighty Red taking on Angela Walters. Now, these two here, Angela Walters has actually been impressing a lot of people, including myself, in previous weeks ever since she originally signed with HCW. So she'll be going one-on-one with the Mighty Red. Mighty Red trying to get a win under her belt here, trying to, you know, build some momentum. And we're basically just looking to see who is worthy to challenge for either the Divas title or the Woman's title. Match number four, Eva Ivanov will go one-on-one with the HCW Divas Champion, Wildcat. Now, this is probably the first match for Eva Ivanov since the HCW season actually took place or started up. She was involved in the HCW Women's Championship Tournament, but I believe this is probably her first official match since then. So we'll see how she does. Of course, Eva being the wife of the Russian Nightmare, Anton Ivanov, who is on Recharged. And our main event. Now, this one here promises to please. I'm very, very excited and ready to see this. We've got Katrina Locke, the HCW Women's Champion, going to go one-on-one with Sophia Evans. Now, both of these women have a mixed martial arts background. They both very, very similar in style. So I halfway expect this match here to not be a classic wrestling match, but more of a hold-for-hold mixed martial arts fight. And, I mean, it's going to be interesting to see what happens here. Now, of course, these two matches right here are non-title match. If Sophia Evans beats Katrina Locke, she will automatically get a title match in 2 weeks on the fourth episode of Bombshells for the woman's title. Same thing applies to Eva Ivanov. If she beats Wildcat here today, then she'll get a title shot for the HCW Divas title in 2 weeks. But either way, I think these matches are going to be really, really good. Like I said, we got some rivalry started up. I'm letting Universe Mode kind of play on the women's show, see how these rivalries play out, because I want to make sure that things are going to make sense and be somewhat exciting and fun before I allow Universe Mode to kind of have a little more freedom on Showdown and Recharged. So we'll see how it goes. But either way, so we got five matches. Of course, I'm not going to be commentating. We're just going to let the matches play out. As soon as the show is over, I will come back and we'll discuss the outcome and repercussions like we normally do. So I hope you enjoy the show. And, of course, if you do, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe. I do want to thank the several people who have subscribed to this channel over the course of the past few weeks now. I was at, I think, 712 subscribers about probably about 3 or 4 weeks ago, and now I'm up to 751, I believe. So that's pretty good. That's about an average of around between 8 to 10 subscribers a week. So I definitely appreciate all the support, and I hope you guys continue to like the videos and all the series that we're starting here on HCW Call League. But without any further ado, let's go ahead and jump right straight into this show. I hope you enjoyed, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, so that was HCW Bombshells episode 2, and I have to say that was a pretty awesome episode. I mean, these women, they're definitely impressing me in these matches. I was really debating about, you know, keeping the women's division active and keeping this show with all the other things going on the HCW Colleague channel now with me doing new streams and new series and stuff. But after watching these matches today, there's no doubt I'm keeping this show active. You know, we'll see what happens. But either way, we're going to go back over to Carr, talk about what's happened. Kicking off was the tag team match, starting up this rivalry between Simply Heavenly and the team of Duke and Rachel Riley. Last week on Bombshells, of course, Candace Duke and Rachel Riley picked up the victory, but this time it was the other way around with Simply Heavenly picking it up. So now both of these teams have one fall apiece over each other, so it'll be interesting to see where they go forward from here. I don't know what'll happen next week on Bombshells in terms of Universe playing out this rivalry. I don't know if they'll end up, you know, having another tag team match. We'll just have to wait and see what happens next week. A new rivalry that's getting started up here, Goldie Dawson defeating Jennifer Faerkaine in her debut match. And I have to say, that spells volumes right there, her debut, and she's able to knock off Jennifer Faerkaine. And I don't know what the deal is or what the problem is with Faerkaine right now. She seems to be going through the same thing that Smokey went through earlier in the season. She started off strong. She was the first HCW Women's Champion. She lost that to Katrina Locke at Out of the Ashes, and she just has not been able to regroup or rebound since then. I mean, she has had a very, very tough time trying to get any momentum or anything going for her. And I think the frustration is really mounting, and it's building up, and I've got a feeling that something big is going to happen very, very soon with Jennifer Faerkaine, and I got a feeling that Goldie Dawson is probably going to be in a little bit of trouble whenever that happens. So we'll have to see what happens with this rivalry. Match number 3, Angela Walters winning once again against the Mighty Red. And I got to say, you know, Angela Walters is really impressing me. She has done so much here on HCW since her arrival. She's had some incredible matches. She almost won the HCW Divas Championship in that tournament. Whenever she made it to the finals against Wildcat, she came so close to winning that title. And, I mean, to be as short as she is, I think she's 5'4", maybe 5'5". She hangs in there, buddy, and she is just a little short spitfire. That may be her new nickname. I'll call her, you know, short and feisty or short spitfire. I don't know. We'll come up with something for her. But I got, you know, expectations for big things for Angela Walters going forward in the season right here on Bombshells. I can definitely see her becoming a future Divas or Women's Champion down the road. Match number 4. What an incredible matchup this was. Wildcat and Eva Ivanov. And now Wildcat came out and she freaking blew our minds. You know, freaking power bombing, bench pressing Eva Ivanov, throwing her all over the ring like she was a sack of potatoes. But it weren't long after that huge power bomb that Wildcat hit on Eva. It was like that just freaking sparked something in Eva. She got up, she went freaking crazy and just beat the holy horse hell out of Wildcat, kicked her ass from one corner of the ring all the way to the other, and ended up pinning her and winning the match. Now, as a result of that, in 2 weeks' time, on episode 4 of Bombshells, Eva Ivanov will get a shot at the HCW Divas Championship against Wildcat. So we'll see if lightning can strike twice and if Eva Ivanov can, in fact, defeat Wildcat and become the new HCW Divas Champion. That'll happen on episode 4. And in the main event, I tell you, this match, you know, whenever I booked this match, I knew it was going to be good, and it did not disappoint. Katrina Locke able to put Sophia Evans away, but it took 4, if not 5, finishers of those shoulder breakers to put her away. And as you saw just now, it popped up on the screen, Sophia Evans has been named the number one contender because of such an impressive showing in this matchup, and I'm sticking with that. So in 2 weeks' time, we will see Katrina Locke versus Sophia Evans for the HCW Women's Championship. And these two women, I mean, they went out there, they left it all in the ring. You know, I mean, it was no shenanigans. They beat the hell out of each other. Sophia put up the fight of her life. In all honesty, I think that was Katrina Locke's toughest challenge to date. I don't think anybody has taken Katrina Locke to the distance like Sophia Evans did here tonight. So I'm definitely interested and looking forward to their title match on episode 4 of HCW Bombshells. So we got episode 3, of course, will be next Wednesday. We'll see what happens there, but episode 4 will be the big CPV where both the titles will be on the line. So we'll see what happens. But one big note I want to point out here is that right now we have a women's champion and a divas champion. We also have an HCW and an HCW World Heavyweight Champion. Now, Uprising 5 will take place in July, which is what? Let's see, it's February, so that'll be March, April, May, June, 5 months from now. So in 5 months' time, we're going to be unifying the HCW and HCW World Championship as well as the Women's and the Divas Championship. So we'll be unifying those titles at Uprising 5. So, I mean, that's a long time between now and then, so it'll be pretty interesting to see how all of it plays out. But either way, let's go ahead and check out the news here. New number one contender. Yep, we already know that. Sophia Evans has been named the new number one contender after their strong showing in the non-title match against champion Katrina Locke. So we got that one set. Tag team competition begins to heat up as Candace Duke and the doll Rachel Riley take on Heaven and Ashley Good. So we already knew all that. All right. So there you have it. So that was this episode of HCW Bombshells. I hope you enjoyed the show. Don't forget to come back tomorrow for HCW Showdown. It'll be streamed at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time right here on HCW Colleagues YouTube channel. Now, here in about probably 15 to 20 minutes, I'm going to be doing episode 5 of Rocket League. I'm going to go ahead and try to get those done by tomorrow. Go ahead and finish up that series. I've got 12 more games and then the playoffs. So I'm going to go ahead and try to finish up the Rocket League series because I want to get started with Madden 16. And then I plan on getting NBA 2K16 on Friday and starting a series on that as well. So we've also got WWE My Career. I'll be streaming some of that a little bit later today. Probably be around maybe 1 as soon as I get done with Rocket League. So make sure you tune in for that if you're into that series. And I guess that's about it for now. Make sure if you like this show, make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends, your family members, anybody that you know that likes wrestling, likes Original Call, please direct them to our channel. We definitely appreciate it. And make sure that you join the HCW forums if you have not done so already. That's hcw3.boards.net. And while you're at it, go check out The Uncool Dad here on YouTube. He has his own channel set up. Make sure you go check him out. He does various games and stuff, game streams. So I definitely appreciate it if you go check him out. And that'll be it for now. I'll be back in probably about 15 minutes to stream episode 5, of Rocket League. So be tuning in for that. Thanks for watching. This is H.A. Duke signing out.